too long. I've been on the road too much. Had to get back to you. Back to you. Hey guys, what's up? It's Raquel and A. I just want to say, before I start, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, because I noticed from my last video y'all actually subscribe, and I'm very grateful, because y'all, I'm really not a consistent person, but I can actually say over time your girl is gonna have some progress. So today's video is a video that was highly recommended. And wait, hold on, before I get started, I'm gonna wait till y'all subscribe, so go ahead and subscribe. Go ahead. Oh, y'all subscribe? Okay, just making sure. Okay, so I do want to say before I start that the lights might go off, so you might see me get up to turn them back on. I don't know why it's doing that, but today's video is going to be a girl's talk. I do have some questions. Let me make that focus. I had to put some in my notes, y'all, because either people was asking me questions, family, friends, etc., or I was just like, let me talk about some stuff that people actually, you know, stuff you can really talk about. Some of these questions are opinions, so I'm gonna try my best to make sure that I am answering everything the right way. But then again, I just want y'all to know it is my opinion, so don't take offense, because it is not that. So we just want to get started. Question number one is, what is my zodiac sign? My zodiac sign, I am a Cancer. I was born July 8th. I'm a Cancer. If you a Cancer, comment down below if you know a Cancer. Okay, so number two says, what is my relationship status? I am in a relationship. I really don't plan on talking about my relationship in my videos yet, but eventually it will happen. But as of right now, I'm not really trying to get into depth about that. But question number three. If you could travel anywhere, what would it be? Y'all, I want to go to Dubai. Either Dubai or Jamaica. Like, I don't know. I want to go somewhere where the water is just, like, so pretty. And then, yeah. I don't know. So, the next question is, how do you focus on yourself? Okay, y'all. So, me personally, I could be alone. I can do things by myself. Me, the way I started off doing that was journaling. See how the light just went off. Journaling, going outside, taking walks, like just doing things alone, like doing things that make you happy, you know? Good things though, not negative things. That's what I do, so that one. The second question is, how to forgive yourself and move on. Me, my opinion, you have to forgive others. No matter what somebody did to you in the past, do not hold grudges. Hold on, y'all, let me cut this light back on. Okay, so like I was saying is, you have to forgive others. You cannot hold grudges towards people, because you would never grow. Like, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. Anybody that has hurt me or did me wrong in the past, I might not talk to you ever again. But in my heart, I forgive you, but I'm just not gonna never mess with you again. I don't know if that makes sense, but you know, you gotta learn to accept. You gotta learn that, okay, this happened, that was bad. I'm trying to figure out how to say this the right way. Because it's like, I know how to say it the right way to me, but I wanna make sure I'm saying it the right way to y'all. Accept, like it happened, move on. Like, if you can't control it, just don't even worry about it. Give it to God, because at the end of the day, God is gonna bless you regardless, so. Okay, the next question says, tips on moving on. How would I move on from a situation, whether it's a relationship or a friendship? My opinion, I ain't gonna lie, it's hard. It takes time. A relationship is totally different from a friendship, so depending on how long you guys been friends. But I would say, I mean, it's hard, it takes time. The healing process is not always peaches and cream, y'all. You really just gotta take time with yourself and do things that make you happy. Journal. I'm not gonna lie, y'all. Like, a lot of people say journaling doesn't help them. Like, I know some people that say journaling doesn't help them, but it helps me. Like, I'd rather write down my thoughts than constantly vent. Like, I cannot go and vent to somebody and be like, I'm going through this, like, I need to do this. So me, like, my moving on thing, I would just journal, go out, have fun, be around your family and friends, especially people that make you happy. Like, don't go out and party with bitches that wanna just move on to the next one. Oh, let me go call up. Oh, no, that's not the way you're gonna heal. You gotta be around some people that's positive, and you know, because don't go to those type of people, because it's not a 2 to 3 day process. It's really not. Like, it takes time. You have to take time with yourself, because it's a roller coaster. It really is. You gotta take time with yourself, because one minute you'll be feeling shitty and the next minute you'll be feeling good. Toxic people, you gotta cut them off. Like, cut them off now. And yeah, you just gotta take time with yourself. Like, things will be okay. Things will get better. This one says, how do I feel about toxic people? I'm not even gonna lie to y'all, I don't be around nobody that's toxic. Like, I only talk to my family and my boyfriend and maybe three other people that I'm cool with. Toxic people, you gotta cut them off. Like, cut them off now. If you got toxic people in your life right now, or you feel like somebody toxic or doing something fucked up, cut them off now. Right now. Because it only gets worse, honestly. Whether it's a friendship or a relationship. And if it's a relationship, cut them off now. Okay. So number 4 says situationships. Just don't even entertain me. Because you'll be talking to this person, dating this person, and just like, just all I gotta say is, don't block your blessings. Do not block your blessings for somebody that's not treating you right. It's not it. So just put you first. Don't even worry about it. So the next question is putting yourself first selfish? Putting yourself first is not selfish. Whether it's a friend, whether it's whoever, you come first. Honestly, put yourself first, because at the end of the day, all you got is yourself. I'm sorry to say this, like, I'm not saying it as if my family, friends, people, they're not there for me. So just live life to the fullest, put yourself first, be happy, and just keep doing things that make you happy. That's all. The next question, how do I feel about relationships? I would say, don't bring your relationship to social media. I would say that. Most of the time, 9 times out of 10, you putting your relationship on the internet. I mean, I'm not saying it's not good to post, but I'm saying, like, you putting your business on social media. If you're gonna get in a relationship, make sure it's somebody that actually cares about you genuinely, that supports you, that's gonna be there for you no matter what. It's year, 2022 right now? It's gonna be 2023? we dating to marry now. We not dating for the bullshit. Like, time to grow. It's really time to grow, like, you know what I mean? But the next question says friendship advice. I'm not even gonna lie to y'all. I only have maybe a total of 3 friends that I actually trust. I really don't have that many friends. I would say that if you gonna call somebody your friend, make sure you trust them. 9 times out of 10, females be on some messy shit. Like, the shit be lame as fuck. And we just not dealing with that. And me, I stay out of drama. I stay away from people that I know is in drama. I gotta keep my peace. Like, I can't deal with that. So the next one says dating advice. Like I said, make sure you're with someone who supports you, who genuinely care for you. You can tell when somebody is right for you. You can tell when somebody is wrong for you. Just make the right decision. Don't backtrack. Please do not backtrack, y'all. We besties, okay? We're besties. So, me talking to you, bestie. Do what makes you happy. Make sure you're with somebody who makes you happy. And don't settle for shit. The next one says how to be okay with being single. Me personally, I'm okay with being single. Like, if I'm in a relationship, I'm happy. If I'm by myself, I'm happy. Like, I think I learned how to be happy by myself before trying to get in a relationship. But I'm not gonna lie to y'all. This gotta be a whole nother talk. Tips on how to have self-confidence. Y'all, I'm not gonna cap to y'all. A long time ago, I used to be so insecure. Like, now I'm not. Like, I feel like I'm really humble. Just, like, wear things that makes you comfortable. Like, do your hair somewhere you like it. Take pictures. Girl, I don't know. Okay, the next one says tips on how to enjoy your own company. I can do things by myself. Like, I literally do stuff by myself all the time. I can go to the movies by myself. I go work out by myself. I can go walk around by myself and still be feeling good. Like, I don't know. And it's like, I don't even care to do it by myself. And most people think it's weird. Me personally, I be feeling good. You telling me it's weird. You're telling me it's weird and I'm feeling good. Like, what's up? So the next question says, uplifting others. You really gotta be around people that are uplift you, because there's a lot of people that's really negative, judgy, self-centered. When you're around people, you'll feel good. Like, you feel the energy. You can talk to them about anything, vent about anything, and you will know that person's not gonna go behind your back. I mean, I feel like if you have a friend and they positively bring good energy around you, you know that person's a good friend. Like, you like uplifting others is a good thing to do. Most people just want to have drama, and it's like, we're not doing that. This one says, how do I feel about people who constantly bring others down? People like that makes me sick. I hate negative people. I really hate negative people. I don't like people that's not supportive. I can go on and on with the list, but I feel like people that put others down is upset about themselves or insecure with themselves. That's how I genuinely feel. Okay, y'all, but this is the end of this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to your girl. I don't know, y'all. I'm so happy because I'm really putting content out for y'all. I'm really trying. I'm really being consistent, and I just feel so good. Until then, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on your post notifications, and y'all, leave me suggestions down in the comments below. But until then, that's all, folks.